Hey my lovelies, welcome back to my channel. Welcome to all you newbies. Thanks for subscribing, I really appreciate all of you. So today we're going to be doing message from someone's heart. You know, maybe they can't tell you, maybe you haven't seen this person in a while, you know, that kind of thing. So for pile one we have the Emperor. Pile two we have the Lovers. And for pile three we have the Empress. So guys, don't forget, take what resonates, leave what doesn't, don't force anything, okay? If it's not your pile, choose another pile, and don't forget these are energies as well, guys, okay? So I see you at your piles. Hey group one, so if you chose the Emperor jar, this is your reading, I'll stick him there. So these are the cards that flew out for you lot. Actually, I've got to say, with while shuffling for everyone's piles, bloody cards were just like literally just flying everywhere. So I thought, okay, I'll take them, because obviously spirit wants to tell you lot something. So let's start your reading. So we've got watching you. They've been watching your social media to see what you post and get clues to know how to approach you. Then we have Dark Knight. They're experiencing massive upheaval to help them align with new levels of love with themselves and the connection. Okay. The player lifestyle that once defined everything they did has stopped looking enticing ever since they met you. It's good to know. Power couple. They see that both of you have an equal exchange of power, which can make you unstoppable as a couple. And we have sexual union. This is great. Their greatest sex memory is with you, but it's more than just sex. It's their memory of feeling close to you. And I can't speak today. Anyways. This is really... I'm liking this. So... for some, my throat just went there. So for some of you, okay, I don't know why I'm picking that up. So for some of you, you may have actually called things with this person a bit, because, you know, with that Dark Knight there, it may have been that they may have had some things that they needed to deal with. It could be this player energy that they were carrying around with them, okay? So maybe you backed off a bit. Hence why they're still watching you to see what you're doing, what you're posting, whether you've met anyone. And it's like they are going through like the dark night of the soul. I'm hearing cleansing. It's like you've done something to them here. And this sexual union here as well, it's like the card says, it's not just about sex, it's the memory of you. You've definitely done something to this person. I'm actually hearing that this because of the player card, I'm really drawn to that card. It's like this is the type of person that no one could actually ever tie down. It's not really the nicest word to put it. Lock them down. You know what I mean. I mean, that just sounds really bad in general, just saying it out loud. But there's something different about you, okay? It's like they can't sit. Trying to get it out. Look at the way he's looking back. It's like even though he's tried to maybe walk away, and I'm saying he because it's a he card, okay? She or he. They're still looking over their shoulder, you know, being drawn back to you. The thing is as well, I feel like with this card here, with the power couple, I'm looking at these two in the picture as the Queen of Wands and the King of Wands, which is like, they are the power couple in the tarot deck. They are very attractive people in the tarot deck. That's how I'm seeing you. It's like, I feel like when you two walk into a room, everybody is just like, maybe a bit envious. They can't help but stare, okay? So it's like this person wants you to know that they haven't forgotten you, okay? maybe you are with this person and this is what's happened and this is how, you know, you, both of you may have got together, but they're saying that they're still drawn to you. They're still watching you. Yeah, let's have a look. So tell me more about this energy here. What's the message from their heart to group one? What message do they have for group one from their heart spirit? Wow, the sun. You've healed something in this person. This is what you've done. Like I said, it's like you've changed this person. Not that you went out of your way to say, right, you've got to change, right, you've got to do that. You're, that's not it at all. Just you being you, group one, changed this person from the way they used to be. It's like nobody... It's like, oh, this sounds so bad, but this is what the energy I'm picking up on. It's like a one and done kind of thing. That sounds so terrible, but that's what I'm picking up. A one and done energy here. But you, it wasn't like that at all. Once wasn't enough. Twice wasn't enough. You know, they need more. So you've actually healed them. They're now seeing you as their happiness here with the sun, okay? That you've now made them see that maybe they were fearful of relationships or committing themselves to someone. Maybe they now realise it's not as bad as they thought it was going to be. Or it could just be you as a person. So they're telling you here that you've brought a lot of happiness into their life. You make them very happy. You've healed their playaways, okay? And, you know... this transformation here with the dark night. It's like they've had an ego death. It's just like a big transformation. I'm loving it. Yeah. Oh. Four of Pentacles. Yeah, look. I'm like this. Tell me more. Two of Wands, Queen of Pentacles. Let me just get one more. Yeah, look, this is very positive, okay? Strength. This is very, very positive, group one. I love this for you guys. This person doesn't want to let you go, okay? They want to hold on to you very tightly. You mean a lot to them. They may feel a bit possessive over you, okay? You know, which is a nice possessiveness, not, you know. So for some of you, if it's the case, like I said, that you're not with this person at the moment, you may have had something with them and you're giving them time to do what it is that they need to do. They're holding on, you know, and there's hope here, and they're coming to some sort of decision here in regards to you because they see how valuable you are with the Queen of Pentacles here. They know that you are so valuable, and they would be an idiot to let you go, okay? Usually, this energy here wouldn't really want to give to anybody else. Like I said, it would be like, you know, they get their fun or whatever, and they're off again. But with you, they want it to be equal, okay? They want to give to you as well as you give to them, you know? And they're finding the strength here to maybe speak up about this, telling you, they may want to tell you they want more. So, you know, we've got Taurus, Virgo, Capricorn here. Hang on. So tell me about this Two of Wands. Tell me about the Two of Wands for group one, please. Yeah, look, Seven of Pentacles. Tell me more about the Two of Wands. You know, they know you're being patient, okay? Yeah, look. It's literally just described the person that... This card is describing the person, the Knight of Wands. Do you know what? ignore me today, honestly. I'm all over the place. I can't speak. I've just described the person exactly the way the Knight of Wands is seen, a player energy, okay? This person has experienced a huge tower moment in their life. It's like a big wake-up call that you are what's important here, and they can't keep being destructive, you know. Because if anything, they're only actually punishing themselves when they do this. It's like something happened to them maybe when they were younger, and this is that dark night of the soul here. They've got to deal with that. That could be why they don't want to commit. It could be, you know, maybe that, I don't know why I'm hearing that, parents may have had a very turbulent relationship and they experienced a lot of that growing up, hence why they don't want commitment, you know. And they know they're delaying the inevitable here with you, okay? And they know you're being very patient with them, and they appreciate this about you. See, this is good news, the Six of Wands. Good news. Nine of Cups. Four of Wands. Ace of Wands. This is beautiful. Look at this. So we've got Leo, Aries, Sagittarius as well. So yeah, this energy of this person here, the player, because this is a player card. Okay, we've got the player. Their experience, a death here, is exactly what I said at the beginning. This is about to come to an end. So we've got victory here, which is, you know, success, good news. It can be a reconciliation here, a reunion between two people. That's what they want. Then we've got the wish card here, which is the Nine of Cups, talking about success, happiness. They see you as wish fulfillment. It's really nice. Then we've got the Nine of Swords. Then we've got the Four of Wands, which is the Twin Flame card. Then we've got the Ace of Wands. So, you know, it could be that maybe they're worried that you may not want to give them another chance. So they are stressing about this. For some of you, if you're not with this person at the moment, they could be having a lot of anxiety in coming forward and speaking their truth, because maybe this person's actually like a closed book. Maybe they don't open up. So yeah, there's a lot of worry, a lot of sleepless nights here. It could even be because they're going through this death here, not physical death, okay? It could be causing a lot of sleepless nights. Maybe they've shed a few tears over what they've gone through, you know, facing their past, facing their fears. So that's the energy that they're in at the moment. They're very worried here, but they see you as the Four of Wands here, which is, you know, family. They see you as home. You know, Four of Wands speaks of getting married, starting a family, and moving in together, buying a home, celebrations, weddings. I mean, we can go on and on and on, reunions. And then we have the Ace of Wands, which is a brand new beginning. It's a second chance. And I do feel like this person wants a second chance with you, okay? So if you want to give this person a second chance, this is, you know, Spirit saying to go for it here with the Ace of Wands. This is a new romance, or it's a, you know, reconciliation again. So let's get some advice for you, okay? Another thing I'm hearing here as well, group one. You could be in a connection with this person that started off as friends with benefits, okay? You know, something casual. This person telling you, I don't really want a commitment. That kind of thing. and the tables have turned on this person. I'm getting this quite strongly, actually. And the biggest fear here is their feelings has changed here. They want more, but I feel like they're fearful to actually speak up about this because you may reject them. This is what they're worried about, okay? So there's two scenarios here for you guys. So take what resonates, okay? So let's get some advice. What advice would you give group one? Please, Spirit. Wow, Ten of Pentacles. Can't get any better than Ten of Pentacles. Spirit is saying, if you were to give this person a chance, okay, if you wanted more from them. Oh, excuse me. I really should stop drinking fizzy drinks when I'm doing my readings. I end up burping. Spirit is saying, if you want to go forward with this person, you've got this guaranteed Ten of Pentacles here. This is happily ever after. It's financial stability. It's a long-term commitment. It's growing old together. It's family. It's generational wealth. It's just everything. Pure abundance, this is, in the relationship as well as financially here. You know, that this is something that can be very successful here. I mean, this could be your twin flame here because we do have the twin flame card. And sometimes, you know, with twin flames, one of the partners has to go through like a ego death or the dark night of the soul. And I feel like this is what this energy needed to do. Because one's always working at a higher vibration than the other one. So what more advice would you give group one? Look at this death. Wow. So they don't want you to walk away from them. They don't want you to end things with them, okay? They want a renewal here with you. They want to start again. They want to tell you that they've changed. They've left all this playaways in the past. And with the Three of Wands here, this is somebody that is very hopeful for the future, okay? You know, they're pining, they're yearning, yeah, they're really like, they've got really strong feelings for you, this person. It's like they really miss you. So for the other group, you know, the other ones that I said about, you're not with this person, and they may have gone off to sort themselves out, they are really, really missing you here. They're waiting for the opportunity to come forward. It could even be you guys, group one, that is, you know, waiting for this person to return. You know, this is big changes that are about to happen. It's whether do you want this change or not. So what more advice would you give group one? Ooh. Princess of Princess of Pentacles. This is somebody that is very loyal, okay? To you anyway. They see you as a friend, not just, you know, a lover. They see you as a friend that they can talk to. So they see you as their equal here. You know, we did have the Six of Pentacles as well. And this is also a messenger card as well. So this is some kind of communication. So Spirit is saying, the advice to you is expect some kind of communication here from this person. They're gonna put a stop to you two, you know, not being together here. They want to start again. They want a rebirth here, basically. So, right. Oh, my God. I've got so many cards out. Let's have a look at these first for you. Some oracle cards. Can't remember what these are bloody called. But anyway. So for group one, Spirit, what more do they need to know from this person's heart? common law union, you may have a living relationship that is bound by love without the matrimonial rules. Okay, so you know, if you two do this, it could be that you don't get married, but there is a lifelong commitment here. Okay, so it's like common law man and wife, just without the paper. Let's get a few more for you. On again, off again. Someone's entering your life, you may disappear and reappear. Don't get trapped in this cycle. And I feel like that is like literally the Knight of Wands and that player card, okay? This is why I said at the beginning, I feel like some of you, you're not with this person. You may have like said to them, you know, go off, sort yourself out, sort your head out. And this is where they've had this big change of heart here when it comes to relationships, and especially with you. Okay, for some of you, if you're still in this like friends with benefits or whatever, and this is the kind of energy that you're dealing with, just be made aware, like I said, this person does want more, but maybe you need to set boundaries if that's the case with the on and off and off, you know, on and off again. Protected by love. Your partner will be protective of you, feeling an obligation to rake to. Oh my god, maybe I shouldn't have done a reading today. Oh, scary moment. To take care of you, just be sure it's not possessiveness. Did I say that this? Yes, I did. The Four of Pentacles, I did say that this person may be a bit possessive over you, okay? Because I feel like what that is that, like I said about their childhood, okay, and they've never experienced this with anybody before. You are somebody that is different, so there may be a bit of this possessiveness when it comes to you, because they don't want to lose that, okay? So maybe set boundaries with them. Don't let them get a bit OTT with you guys, okay? And then we've got opposites attract. Someone may enter your life who's very different from you. You will complement each other. So yeah, I feel like you two opposites attract. You know, they say opposites attract, don't they? So let's get some of my cards here. So what does this energy want to say to group one? Okay, so it says, when I'm having sex with the karmic, I think of you. So for some of you, if this person has gone off and they're still doing this, they are still thinking of you. Okay, I know that's kind of creepy, but anyway, that's for some of you, not all of you. So what is this? I want to right all my wrongs. Good. I started seeing someone new, but they cannot replace you. Okay, so they may be off doing whatever at the moment, trying to sort their head out, and this is coming back full circle. The guilt is killing me over how I treated you. Yeah, if they're in and out all the time, messing you about, they obviously, their heart is saying, you know, I feel really guilty for doing that to you. So let's get some of these. Okay, so abundance, which reminds me of the Ten of Pentacles, that card does. Yeah, I feel like this would be very rewarding, you know, satisfying, you know, just pure joy for both of you here. If this person could pull their finger out their backside for 5 minutes, you know? I mean, don't forget, this could have already happened to you. You could already be with this person, and it's just your story that's coming out, you know, if you've tuned in. Then we have intimacy and life purpose. Right, and that is the thing here with this card. What I was trying to explain at the beginning, they've never experienced this with anybody else. You do something to them, and I feel like it is intimacy as well. It's like you're teaching them Oh, I love that card. And then life purpose, you know. I feel like you're there to teach this person. A lesson's not very, I don't know how to phrase it. The only way I can phrase it is by saying to teach this person a lesson that not all relationships are doom and gloom. It's like, look at this card as well, her heart. I feel like you're opening their heart here to love. Okay, let's get a couple of these for you. Abundance again, geez. You two, there's something very special about you two, and I did say twin flame. Lucky times are ahead of you, along with good news, success and prosperity. And I see news is coming towards you here from this person. Do you know what? Don't even really need to bloody go on. Transformation on the back of the deck. Reach out for power and strength to make changes and reach your life and become the person you want to be. And that is exactly what this person is going through at the moment. This big transformation here. Absolutely love it. Your reading's lovely. I'll get you one of these. I don't know about these cards sometimes, but I pulled them out for a reason. There must have been a reason for that. Find deeper meaning and personal growth amid the discomfort. Yeah. See, look, even though it's very uncomfortable for this person to, you know, get a grip on their feelings here, it may be uncomfortable, but it's saying here, you know, find a deeper meaning. And they are growing here. You know, you can't just go around in life. Some people do. I mean, I don't know how that brings any satisfaction to anybody, to be honest. I've always been in long-term relationships. I could never flip from one person to the next. Old-fashioned girl. I surrender to the power, to a power greater than me. Yeah, they are surrendering here. And I feel like you lot are as well. You're just leaving it into the divine's hands here. Like, you know, I feel like you guys are quite blasé. If this person's coming back, they're coming back, you know. All right, let's get some of these. I ain't used these in ages. Okay. Ask for help from others. Okay. So maybe you may need a bit of advice from friends and family. Just ask for some help. You need to forgive, okay? Maybe if you're upset with this person, Spirit is saying to please forgive this person. Because honestly, guys, I mean, from the reading the other day, that's why I took a break yesterday. I thought, I need a break. It was so negative, and it was just like, I felt so drained. And it's nice to actually see a really positive reading again here. So Spirit is saying, you know, just forgive this person. Even if you don't want to be with them, forgiveness. And then Spirit saying you are ready. Oh, and remain positive. Because maybe, if you know, I said about yearning and waiting and all that. And maybe you've been waiting for a while for this person to come forward. Spirit is saying just remain positive here, okay? Okay, let me get you a song from this person. Oh, bloody hell. Honestly, so let's get you a song for group one. I'll take that first one that's there. So we've got Lost You. Let me put that there. So we have Lost You by Algara. Didn't know that one. Jesus Christ. Start again. Didn't know that love could change up. Then I woke up to a stranger. After all this time, I thought that I knew you, and I was no debating. Okay, now it's up for conversation. Tell me, was it all a lie? I'm confused, but then you say what I want to hear, because you know it's going to get me here. See, do you know what? This song, I do remember this song now. this speaks, this song, I'll read the rest of it in a minute, of a player energy here, okay? It's like you go to bed with all these promises and then, like, you know, it's just all a lie. And then, like, then they'll come in with the sweet words and the convincing, and then they draw you back in again, and then you're in bed again with them. And this is basically what their higher self is telling you that they did to you, and this is why I feel like they are very sorry for doing this to you, okay? So then we have everything I say that I'm going through, and even though I know it ain't right, said I wasn't going to spend the night, here I am right back with you. Although I lost you, I've always want you, because you take me high, high. See, I'll always want you, but I know I've lost you. So this person's saying that, if, you know, it's coming from you as well as them here, like, you know, you got sucked in, even though you said you didn't want to go there, you ended up back in bed with them. And then, like, this person's saying to you here that, because of the way they treated you, they know they've lost you. So for some of you, that could be the case. But for some of you, I really don't believe that is the case here. I feel like there is still a chance. That could be why this person has got some kind of anxiety and worry here, because they want to come forward and say that they've had a change of heart, that you are someone very special to them. But do they have the guts to do that? I do believe they do. So anyway, group one, I'm going to leave it there. If you like this video, please hit like. I appreciate you. And you take care, guys. Much love. Hey, group two. So if you chose the lover's, card, jar, bottle, this is your reading. Let's put that there. You've got quite a few cards as well. So let's see what this person wants to say from their heart to you. We have dark side. They have a dark side that no one knows and feel it's their true side, but it's too afraid to show you. Okay. Potential. They're deep in their thoughts about you, realizing their distractions prevented them from seeing the potential in you. Lustful desires. I feel like you're dealing with a devil energy here. I knew bad energy would sneak through somehow. Ignore me. Lustful desires. There is a difference between love and lust. Don't let your desire destroy you. Overcome the spirit of lust. Ancestral karma. They had clear and negative ancestral patterns that were passed down through generations. Don't rush the journey. And we have boundaries. They love that you set strong boundaries for yourself and walk away from those who don't respect them, including them. So I feel like this is someone you walked away from, group two. Okay. Sorry if it is an ex that's come through, but, you know, they're sneaky, these exes. They like to sneak their way into readings. So I do believe you strongly that you're dealing with a devil energy here, okay? They may have had sexual addictions here, okay? Very high sex drive. They may have been into some kind of things that you may not have been aware of. Maybe you had an inkling about it, okay? But the problem is they're carrying this karma, this ancestral karma from their ancestors that need to be cleared, because I've learned a lot about ancestral karma because I'm into all that kind of thing. I believe in all that. So basically sometimes, well, not sometimes, the book that I read recently said that with ancestral karma, you volunteer for your ancestors to come to this life to clear the ancestral karma, okay? And usually that will end with you. You know, you'll clear all the ancestral karma, and then whoever's born into the next generations and the next lives and that will not be carrying these ancestral karmas around with them, or karma. I hope I explained that well. And the problem here is they've not done that. They're still carrying this dark side to them. And I feel like you got so fed up with this person that you literally told them to jog on, you know, you put the boundaries in place and you were like, enough's enough now. And they didn't see your potential. They didn't see who you really were, because they're in this darkness here. Okay, let's have a look. Tell me about this dark side. What does this energy want to tell group two? Maybe you were confused as well, you know, why, if they were hiding this from you, you may to this day think to yourself, well, what was it? What went wrong? What was wrong with this person, you know, and you don't know. And this is their higher self coming through now and telling you what it is that you need to know. So we have the Seven of Rain, the King of Ashes, the Six of Ashes. Let me get a couple more. So Rain is the Seven of Cups, Ashes is Wands, and then we have Ten of Wands, Three of Rain, Three of Cups, and we have Pentacles, Messenger of Pentacles, and Five of Wands. Okay. This person can't stop thinking about you. They can't get you out of their mind. This King of Ashes here, constantly thinking about you with the Seven of Cups. Six of Cups is all about reconciliation, nostalgia, thinking about the past, you know, all the good times that you had, you know, memories with you, maybe looking at old photographs, you know, that they just can't stop thinking about what they let go here, you know, what they lost. And now it's like they're walking around with this weight on their shoulders, because if you look at this card here, look at the way he's trying to hold up the cave here. So he or she is carrying this weight around with them, maybe guilt, sorrow, grief, I'm hearing as well. This person's exhausted, constantly going over and over and over it here. They want you to know that they're exhausted. You're exhausting them, basically. Yeah, but they didn't learn. So the King of Wands, very good looking energy. This is, you know, someone that's very handsome or very pretty. So we've got Leo, Aries, Sagittarius here. This is someone that is very charming, very confident, you know. When they're in a room, you know they're in a room, okay? People are drawn to them. They want to approach you here, okay? They do want to reach out with this Messenger of Stones, the Page of Pentacles. But there might be a rival here. You may have already moved on with someone else, group two, okay? There's outside influences preventing this person from coming forward. So it could even be that maybe they're in another relationship with the Three of Cups. I'm going to clarify that. I cannot speak today, so excuse me, okay? So, yeah, it could be that they're in another relationship. But I'm picking up very strongly that you may already be in a committed relationship. You may even be married, okay? But something is preventing them from reaching out to you here. Let's have a look what it is. Tell me about this Three of Rain. Oh God, lost justice and enlightenment, which is judgment. Ace of Pentacles, you moved on. This is what stops them from you went into a new beginning here, okay? Could have been that, like I said, you may have got married, you're just in a committed relationship, you've moved on. And this is justice, basically, you know. Karmic justice, really. If they weren't treating you very well, maybe they had a dark side to them that would come out every now and again. Maybe they lost their temper with you. Um, and enlightenment, which is judgment here. I feel like this person's receiving karma here. And you know, you've got ancestral karma here as well. And the problem is here, this person doesn't realise, or maybe they have realised, but I feel like they want to come and say sorry, okay? They want to do right by you. That's why they want to message you. I feel like because they're being tortured by whatever it was that they did to you, okay? It's like they just can't seem to get rid of it here, and they think maybe if they come forward and they say sorry and they do the right thing by you with these two cards of judgment and justice here, that it will ease up a bit on the karma here, okay? Maybe it will. Because the enlightenment is being enlightened to something, isn't it? It's like having that clarification that, oh crap, I've hurt a lot of people in my life and now I need to go and make right what I did wrong, put it back together. But what stops them, like I said, is because maybe they're fearful of stepping on toes. If you're in a relationship, maybe you've got them on block here. So we've got Taurus, Virgo, Capricorn, and we've got Libra as well, guys. So tell us more, Spirit. What does this person want to say to group two? What more do they want to say? They want to right their wrongs, is what I keep hearing. But they do want to let you know here that they've never forgotten you. So what more does this person want to say to group two? You stubborn. Three of Ashes, which is the Three of Wands in reverse. This person wants to return. They do, they want to return. This is returning from being away for so long. But they feel like they can't, because it's like Spirit is clipping their wings here. It's like, you know, you can't go towards group two here. Tell me about this Three of Wands in reverse. The Moon. They feel stuck. It's stones again. They want to move on. They want a new beginning. They want a fresh start. They want to just lay all this to rest. But Spirit's not letting them. Because I feel like here, they've not dealt with the darkness that is inside of them, okay? They've not dealt with... they've not dealt with this darkness. This is why their wings is being clipped here, from being able to move forward with anything, really. Person still holds a lot of feelings for you, okay? A lot of emotions, and that's buried deep. They want a new perspective here. It's about a new beginning here, but they also know that they may need to sacrifice themselves, basically, you know, give up on coming forward and apologizing or talking to you here. They know it may not go anywhere, may not do anything. I don't know, this person, it's like I keep hearing they can't reach you, they can't find you. So unless you've got your social media on lockdown here, I mean, it could even be family and friends here that are stopping this person from approaching you, okay? Because I feel like they've done a lot of damage, so they're just trying to protect you. Tell me about this Moon. What does this person want to say? Tell about the moon, please, spirit. Six of Rain. Ten of Wind, which is the Ten of Swords. Yeah, what they're holding on to is a reconciliation with you, a reunion. The memory of you, like I said earlier, is just buried so deep. I don't think this person has expressed this to anybody. You know, the Emperor can be already in a relationship themselves. This person could even be the father or the mother of your children as well, because if you look at that card with the child, and then the Emperor is usually a father figure, the divine masculine here. But they're in the Ten of Swords. They want you to know that they hit rock bottom, okay, or they're at rock bottom right now, okay. They could be having problems with their back, you know, a bit of illness there, maybe a bit of arthritis. I don't know where that come from, but that is what I'm getting here. They want you to know that when it came to an end with you, it was the most painful thing that they've ever gone through, okay. Group two, I actually feel really sad. I'm picking up on this person's emotions. You know, like when you're just on the verge of crying, and I don't bloody cry. Hardly, anyway. Call me a cold fish. It takes a lot to make me cry, but I'm actually feeling really, really emotional. I do feel like this person, that you guys are their karma here. The loss of you. Let's see what advice Spirit wants to give you guys, okay? So what advice would you like to give? I'm just hearing sorry, okay? It's like, I can't reach you. And, you know, hopefully you see in this reading is their apology to you. They recognise exactly what they did to you here. I can't see exactly what it was that they did. They're not really letting that out at the moment. Well, they're not letting it out at all. It's like, it's hidden from me, but you guys would know what they did. But this is just them saying how sorry they are. So what advice would you give group two? The Tower. So we've got Messenger of Ashes, which is the Page of Wands, Queen of Rain, which is the Queen of Cups. Yeah, look. Spirit's advice to you is just continue doing you, okay? Continue on your life journey with your partner here. Like I said, I do believe you guys have already moved on, because we do have the Ten of Cups here. Look at this. I love this card. Look how happy they are, you know. You've got your little family. You've got your happy ever after here, okay? Spirit is saying to you, for you to start talking to this person again, it's going to end up causing a tower moment in your life. They will bring devastation, okay? They've not let go of this dark side, this whatever it is that they've got going on with themselves. It's not gone, okay? So they would just end up breaking what isn't broken, if you know what I mean. I hope you understand what I'm saying here. So don't go down that road, is what Spirit is saying. I mean, everybody's got free will. You do what you need to do, okay? But spirit is really saying, please don't open that can of worms. Spirit, look, you may still have feelings for this person, okay? Or you may have actually really loved this person, but they took advantage of you and now you're in love with somebody else. You know, like I said, you've moved on. We do have the messenger card here, which is the Page of Wands. This is like a phone call or a text message. A bit worried about that. Hang on. Tell me about the page, the Messenger of Ashes. It's got Cancer, Scorpio, Pisces as well. Leo, Aries, Sagittarius again. Yeah, look, what did I say right at the beginning of the reading? This is a devil energy, and look what literally has just come out, the devil. There is a message coming here with the messenger here, Ace of Wind. You can't trust, the spirit is saying, do not trust this person. They've not changed, they're still dark, okay? They still have addictions, they still have problems. If they were, you know, abusive or controlling, anything like that, they've not changed here. So we've got Capricorn energy here. You've already experienced things with this person here, okay? You've already been shown the truth with the Ace of Swords here. You don't need to hear it again. You don't need to open that door again, okay? But this is another messenger card, but it's coming from the devil. So just be careful, okay, guys? There's that spirit's advice to you here. You know, you open that door, you start talking to this person again, it can cause a tower moment in your life. Everything you've built for yourself could end up crumbling down because of this one person here. Right. Let's get some oracle cards here. Oh. Okay, do I do that? I'll do that again. Just literally just flew out. Wow. Please wait for me. Okay. Jesus, this person's got a lot to say. I cannot let go. I am too selfish. Well, yeah, stubborn energy for you. Your body drives me wild. What else does this person want to say to group two? Oh, the bloody card's going to go flying again. Me off now. This energy just wants to throw all the freaking cards out. It would be all day. Your love for me was always unconditional, yeah, but I don't believe your love was unconditional for group two. I'm talking in the third person here. Let's get some oracle cards. Do you know what? New romance, new love will find its way to you. There's an opportunity to experience a positive new beginning. So like I said, you guys met somebody else. You guys may not have met someone yet, that's for some of you, and there's a new romance here for you. That could be why they're saying wait for me. Wait for what? So for group two spirit, what more do they need to know about this energy here? Come on. The score. Who is playing who? Somebody here is looking to score, but only play if you are willing to lose the game. Yeah, there's another warning there again. I don't know. The devil energy is so it's not complicated, but there is so many dark things, you know, surrounding the devil here. So it could be this person does like to play mind games or does like to play games because they get a buzz out of it. So just be careful, because if you're in a relationship here and you're all good, this person could come along and mess with your mind again, if that's the way they used to be. Sacred bond. You will have a spiritual connection that will allow you to see yourself through the person you love. Yep, you've got this bond with the person that you're with, okay? And you know, like it says here, you will see yourself through the person you love. I feel like the person you're with shows you the respect and the love that you deserve. This person really didn't. It's very funny though, they're very sneaky about what they did to you here, because usually I can get, you know, it will come out or I'll get to the bottom of it. Not that I really asked, but yeah, they're just not wanting to really reveal that. Secret lover. The relationship will be kept a secret. Just be sure the decision is okay with both of you and not one-sided. But that could be what this is about, where I just literally said, I didn't know what this person did to you. Maybe that is what this was. Maybe there was cheating, you know, because we do have the Three of Cups that can be seen as a third party or third parties. So they may have had someone on the side that you wasn't aware of. Let me get something for you here. Group two. Look at this. Marriage. Yeah, I do believe you guys are married. Or just in a serious relationship. Pardon me. Because of the Ten of Pentacles. The Ten of Cups, sorry. You know, you are attracting emotional fulfillment and unconditional love. Don't let this person come and ruin this if this is what you've got, group two, okay? Eagle. You will soar towards your destiny with greater clarity and strength. Yeah, I feel like you coming out of this gave you, you know, we've got the Ace of Swords, which is mental clarity, okay? It's made you stronger. Let's get a little bit of advice from these. I honor how I want to feel. Yeah, and you want to feel respected, loved. And this person obviously didn't do that. The universe works fast when I'm having fun. So it could be that you're having a load of fun. It could be that you manifested good things, you know, that your relationship that you're in now. So I'm going to get a song from this person here. Maybe you don't really want to hear it, but I'm going to get you a song. Okay, group two. So what does this energies... What song does this energy want to tell group two? Be With You by Akon. I know they want to come and separate us, but they can't do us nothing. You're the one I want, and I'm a continue loving, because you're considered wifey and I'm considered husband, and I am always be there for you. And either way you look at it, I ain't going nowhere from my muffin, because you're gonna hold it down. Sorry. Can't nobody tell her nothing. You got the kind of love that always make up after fussing, and that's what gets me closer to you. So if you know that song, Akon, Be With You, this person wants to be with you, okay? Like I said, they're not. They consider you wifey material. I mean, for some of you, maybe, you know, you want to get back with this person. I really don't don't see that. Really don't. But, you know, there may be a little small amount of you that want to, and this person sees you as wifey material. But I feel like you're either wifey or hubby material already, you know, with somebody else, not with this person. Okay, so group two, I'm going to leave it there. If you like this video, please hit like. Much love, guys. Bye. Hey, group three. So if you chose the Empress, this is your reading. So let's have a look what this person wants to say from their heart to you. We have innocence. The innocence and kind heart makes them love you, but they feel they must push you away to protect you from themselves. Okay. Coldness. They feel you pulling away. They wish they can pull you back and convince you they're worth keeping. The journey. This love journey may be long and challenging, but so long as you are with them, you'll never walk alone. Toxicity. The toxic friendships are creating distance between you two and preventing them from seeing the purity of your soul. Okay. Divinely guided. You have met your divine flame. Just follow the signs and your soul and everything will occur in divine timing. You may have met your twin flame, but it... by the looks of it, your twin flame's not caught up with you here, okay? They could be telling you that you know, they really recognize that you are their twin flame. I feel like this has been very rocky between you two, you know, even with the toxicity here, okay, whoever this is coming from. And it's like a never-ending journey here, you know, like this long, hard slog. And it could be that now, group three, you're just at this stage that you're just like, can I be bothered? Is it worth it? You know, I feel with this coldness card, I'm seeing the Five of Pentacles here, which is, you know, coldness, feeling depressed, feeling down, you know, distancing yourself from someone here. This person thinks you're innocent here, you know. I don't believe you are innocent, okay? Not meaning that in a bad way. I feel like they're just not seeing you for who you are. And this friendship crap here as well. It could be that this person's easily influenced by friends and family. Maybe you're just not up to their standards in the type of person that they would want you them to be with. But spirit is like giving them a nudge, saying like, this is the person you should be with. But it's like, tell me more, what does this person want to say to group three from their heart, spirit? What they wanted to say. This person what to say. Oh, let me just cover that a minute. Hang on, wait a minute. Where's my blue tack? I swear I've got a ghost in this bloody place. Hang on. That ain't gonna work. I'm just going to cover that card like that, okay? Ignore that, that's from the other group. It's an inappropriate card. Got to be careful. So we've got the King of Wands. We have the Lovers. Eight of Cauldron, which is the Eight of Cups. Which literally just, yeah. The High Priestess. And on the back of the deck, we have the Ace of Swords. Yeah, you walked away from this person, or you're considering to walk away from this person, okay? You do have a choice to make when it comes to this situation here with this energy. They don't want you to walk away. They want you to choose them here. And it could also be maybe regret. Maybe they walked away from you, okay? And there's huge regret here. I feel like they didn't show you what they're saying here. They didn't really show you their true self to you, okay? They kept a lot of things secret from you, a lot of things hidden from you. And they wish they'd told you the truth here with the Ace of Swords. This person still finds you very, very attractive with the King of Wands here. They're very, you know, still very sexually attracted to you, okay? Very passionate about you. So we have Leo, Aries, Sagittarius, Gemini here as well. It could have been maybe they chose somebody else over you here. They made the wrong choice. It could have been, okay, with this toxicity, with the friends and family and that, it could have been that maybe they made the wrong choice here by walking away and listening to other people here and not making up their own mind. And now they realise the mistake that they made here. Let's have a look. Tell me about this Eight of Cauldrons. Tell me about the Eight of Cauldrons. It's come out again. The Ace of Swords, there's an important message there with that. Tell me about this Ace of Swords. The Hierophant. Okay. They want you to know. I feel like it was family that got involved here. Could be friends as well, but mainly family. This person comes from a different background, different culture to you, different, you know, just different. This is why I said that it could be that you just was not the type of person that they would like to have seen this person with, okay? And they want you to know that it was, you know, maybe religious background, but they didn't listen to their intuition here. They wish they had listened to it, and now they've got this mental clarity here that they messed up, basically. Tell me more. What else does this person want to say to group three? You know, they could have gone and married somebody else with the Hierophant here. So we've got Taurus energy as well. What else do they want to say, Spirit? Come on. Hangman, and that's come out like that, which is a new beginning. It's Two of Cups. They're saying they invested in somebody else here, okay? Maybe outside pressures, like I said. And they realise now that, with the realisation of the Hangman here, is that they made a big mistake here. You know, the Ace of Pentacles is going off and starting anew, you know, building a life with someone. But it didn't work out that way. They feel trapped here. If anything, their journey with the person that they chose has not been smooth sailing. They now realise that you are their soulmate here. There's still love for you here as well. They got this mental clarity here from Spirit. But they messed up. Tell us more what this person wants to say to group three, their spirit. What else do they want to say from their heart? Again, the Tower, the Magician. The Magician is all about manifesting something, okay? Trying to make a change, trying to find a way to maybe get out of whatever situation they're in here, trying to break away, but it's like they can't. It's like I keep hearing that you made your bed, you lay in it now. And it's like, with this divinely guided card here with the tower like this, spirit is like literally giving them a nudge, trying to show them the way to go. But this person is resisting it, even though they know they made the wrong choice, that they should obviously be with you, okay? Maybe you don't even want this person, but anyway, this is what's being said here. But they're resisting it. They're fighting against it with the tower on its side here. It's like they just can't catch a break. They can't manifest anything here. Nothing's happening for them here. Their life is crap. And that's not very nice, but... they just can't break away. They're in this, and they're stuck now. Very sad. So what more does this person want to tell? Okay. You haven't seen this person for a long time. I feel like this has been a long time, okay? You've healed from this, okay? This could be someone from your... your way, way past. Maybe you just may have just fucked yourself. Even now, you may even have memories of this person and think to yourself, well, why didn't they choose me? What happened? Why, you know, was I not good enough? It could have been that you walked away from them with this coldness here. I do believe you left it all behind because you were being messed around here. So you do have every now and again these thoughts of, I wonder why or what could have been. And I feel like they do as well. But you've healed from this. They've not. This still plays on their mind. What else? Okay. Ten of... yeah, look. You know, the reason why... Wheel of Fortune. I feel like they're stuck with a karmic here. They chose a karmic over you, which was soulmate connection here. They may have thought that the karmic was a soulmate, but it turned out, no, they're not. This person now has a family, okay? They've laid down roots with this person. They're in it for the long haul. It's too hard to break away from, you know, the relationship, whatever it is that they're in. Tell me about the Ten of Shields. We have Virgo energy as well, guys. And tell me about the Ten of Shields. We have Strength, Nine of Swords, and the Seven of Wands, all in reverse. So, bear with me. Okay, this is a bit of a turnaround. This person wants you to know is that even though they have invested this amount of years, this person's been with their person for a very long time, okay? And they want you to know they're quitting. They've had enough. They're done. They're finding the strength to do this, okay? They know that it was the wrong choice for them. This is why I feel like spirit is stepping in here and trying to guide them back. And I feel like this is all making sense now. With this journey card as well, they've been away from you for so long. You've gone down one road, they've gone down another road, but all roads lead back to Rome is what they say, or you know, that saying there. So you've both gone on different journeys in life, but it feels like that it's about to come full circle again. Now, I did see that obviously didn't think anything of it at the time, but the Wheel of Fortune was actually on the back of the deck twice, and that is something that's coming back full circle. What goes around comes around, you know. So with the Nine of Wands, they're not wanting to compromise anymore. They're not wanting to please whoever they're with. They're not wanting to please family no more, tradition no more. They've had it, is what they're saying. They're finally seeing the light at the end of the tunnel, is what they are telling you. Their conscience, I feel like spirit is messing with them at the moment, that they're I feel like they buried this for so long, okay, with the Merlin here, which is the Hermit, and they've not faced it, you know, letting you go, and their spirit is like nagging them, okay, waking them up here to what was in front of their face and what they should need to do, you know. I'm just hearing time is running out. Yeah, they've given up. Because that was clarifying the Ten of Pentacles here. They literally are giving up on this that they've invested so long into. Oh, that was a bit of a turnaround there. So this person may have some fire up their butt, you know, finally. What else do they want to say to group three? Queen of Swords. Yeah, they're not... Gemini, Libra, Aquarius here as well. They're not using their heart this time. They're not letting anybody play on their heartstrings. They're not getting emotional about this. They've literally become very cold in regards to the people around them and even their relationship here. They're now trying to be very practical. You know, they're trying to use their head here instead of their heart. And they're now being honest with themselves, okay? This could be someone that is going through a divorce. This is someone that is feeling very sad, you know, maybe because of what they've lost and obviously with you. This is someone that has got repressed pain, you know, that they've not been able to ever express this to anybody. So we've got the Six of Wands, which is success, okay, good news, happiness. Someone else I want to say. Yeah, look, and I said about the Five of Pentacles here, Page of Swords, they're spying on you, okay, they are watching you. You may not be aware of that. I feel like they like to see what you're up to. With the Five of Pentacles here, this person could, you know, maybe not be feeling very well emotionally or mentally here. I feel like they just turn cold towards everybody in their life here. It's like resentment is what I'm hearing. They don't care if they end up with nothing. This is what I keep, you know, this is what I'm hearing this person say. I don't care. Sacrificed enough, basically, is what I'm hearing. Seven of Pentacles, Four of Swords, Knight. Yeah, they're single. Or they are, or they're going to be single, you know, because I said could be divorce here. They're working very hard on themselves here. You know, they may need to heal here because, you know, they may have had a bit of depression, okay? So they're taking a rest from it all. They're having a break here. They're waiting. I feel like they're waiting for the right opportunity, maybe to reach out, or maybe they're just waiting. Maybe they don't know whether they want to come forward. Yeah, they're recovering at the moment, okay? This is what they want you to know, is that they are healing. So let's get some advice for you. So what advice would you give group three? What advice would you give group three? What advice would you give group three, please, Spirit? In reverse there. So we've got the Ten of Wands in reverse, Seven of Cups in reverse, Page of Swords in reverse. This person had a lot of things put on them, okay? They had a lot of responsibility. It was like everybody turned to this person with their problems, or you know that if they come from a different background, that's how some of these families are. So it was just so much responsibility on this one person's shoulders, and I feel like that is why they were in this depressive stage here, okay? And they're saying, like Spirit is saying, hang on a minute, guys. Bear with me a minute, because the Page of Swords in reverse, it speaks about, you know, this is advice to you. It speaks about somebody that did not speak up for you, okay? They didn't stick up for you. So it could have been while you were with this person, you may have been bullied by the family members and friends and stuff, and they just, it's like an injustice to you, you know? It was bang out of order. And it's like they didn't defend you at all. But why has that been brought up now? Tell me about this Page of Swords. What's the advice? Page of Swords in reverse. Ah, okay. They want to, yeah, look. This still plays on their mind. They know, look, this definitely still plays on their mind here, is what Spirit is saying. They know they caused an injustice in your life here by not defending you and not sticking up for you here. And they would like to reach out with, you know, this is a communication card. It can be a text message, a letter, you know, an email, but they want to communicate this with you, okay? They want to move forward, you know, they want to come towards you with communication here, okay? Because this still bothers them to this day. This still affects them emotionally, mentally, okay? What they did to you. It's like they can't seem to, like, let it go. It's constantly there in the background. They know they betrayed you here, they backstabbed you, they let other people backstab you, and like I said, they can't let this go. This is still haunting them today. It is still haunting them. They'd like to walk away from this guilt or the remorse that they feel for what they did or put you through, but they can't. Okay, look, Eight of Wands, messages, communication. So let's get some oracle cards for you before I run out of time on my bloody recording. So what message Do we have the parfrey or grapefrey, shall I say, from this person? I didn't like that you saw through all my BS. You are my soulmate. What did I say? Soulmate earlier came out. They now realise that. Or I feel like they realised it years ago. You know, they could have got with somebody else out of, like, you know, obligation, or it could have been a I won't say money thing, but, you know, like, security. What else does this person want to say from their heart, spirit, to group three? Look, I have caught feelings for someone else, and this is what I feel like happened here. I said they went off with somebody else, they married somebody else here, or just had a commitment with them. Yeah, what a big mistake that was. Get a couple more for you. You deserve better than me. They're saying you were just a fling. You know, maybe it was that you caught feelings. Maybe I'm just picking up that this person may have just strung you along, you know. Sexual chemistry. You'll feel a powerful sexual chemistry with someone that will turn into something lasting on a deeper level. So it could end up being that maybe you didn't even get to that stage with this person. Maybe you did. Married with children. Careful not to get entangled with an unhappily married man. Don't allow yourself to be second place. Right, warning here, okay, because this person is going through a separation here, you know. Even though they may have left the person, they could still be clinging on to old wounds, you know. Toxic love. A love interest will seem to bring out the worst in you, but you can't seem to stay away from each other. So it could end up toxic. We've got toxic there, we've got toxic here. So that's a warning as well. Let's get maybe one or two more. Fairy tale romance. This romance will feel magical. It will be an exciting adventure and perhaps a happily ever after. So maybe you guys, like I said, all roads lead to Rome, you know, coming back full circle, you may get that happily ever after. Okay, so let's see what we've got here. Group three, please, spirit. The garden. So this is a fruitful card, you know. This is something that can grow into something beautiful, you know, if that's what you got guys want. Then we have dating. So they may want to ask you out on a date. You may end up dating if you give this person another chance. The distorted feminine. So they could have femininity in them, obviously, divine feminine masculine here. Or they could have been dealing with, like I said, a karmic here, which was the distorted feminine here. You know, like you've got the dark side of the Empress here. Someone that is abusive. She's not very nice, the divine feminine. Seen them in a negative light. Like I said, they thought this person was their soulmate, okay? This could even be the mother of their children or the father of their children here, but they're dealing with a distorted feminine. That's a group three, please. Thank you. The world. Be open to new possibilities in all areas of your life. Yeah. You know, anything is possible. You know, this may take you by surprise. You may not have thought about this person for a very long time. Then they just pop out of the woodwork. But just protect your heart, okay, group three, because it could be that this person is still harbouring a lot of hurt and attachment to their person that they were with. Dragonfly, have confidence during this time of great joy, renewal and connection to spirit. Okay, so it could bring a lot of happiness here. Fire, let go of emotional upheaval and embrace the renewal of the present. So something's going to be reborn here, ignited, if you know what I mean. You know, the flame's going to be lit again. Then we've got the sun, which is open your heart to the enormous growth ahead. So, which is happiness, healing, you know, abundance. We've got that with the garden as well. Let's get some of these for you, group three. Okay, what do you want to say? Let go. Okay. Then we have don't stop. Ask for help from others. And trust. I feel like there's trusting yourself, trusting the Most High. It could be you need to let go of the past here, okay? Don't stop moving forward. Maybe don't even stop hoping is what I'm hearing as well. So I'm going to leave it there, group. Actually, no, I'm not. I'm going to get you a song like the rest of you, the rest of the piles. Hang on, song from this energy here to you. Okay. Look. Alright. Shivers, Ed Sheeran. So, I took an arrow to the heart. I never kissed the mouth that tastes like yours. Strawberries and something more. Oh yeah. I want it all. Lipstick on my guitar. Fill up the engine. We can drive. Yeah, we can drive real far. Go dancing underneath the stars. Oh yeah. I want it all. And it says, I want to kiss your eyes. I want to drink that smile. I want to feel like I'm like my soul's on fire. I want to stay up all day and night. Yeah, you got me singing like, ooh, I love it when you do it like that. And when you're close up, give me shivers. So Shivers by Ed Sheeran. This person says that you give them shivers. So I'm going to leave it there, group three, okay? If you like this video, please hit like and you have a lovely day. Much love, guys. Mm-hmm.